Hello everybody, welcome to the Kinco VFD Hardware Inspection Guide. Today we got here the Kinco FV20 to show you the process of VFD maintenance. To start with, you need a multimeter and a screwdriver. If the inverter is abnormal, open the case to see if the PCB boards are connected normally, and whether there is any burnt or other abnormalities. When checking the control panel, the first thing is to check whether the power indicator light on the control board is normal. After the inverter is powered on, you can see that the LED lights next to the CPU on the control board will light up. If the LEDs do not light up, it means that the 5V power supply of the driver board is abnormal. Next will be the wiring terminal inspection of the control board. Use the voltage range of the multimeter to measure the voltage between 10V and GND and to see if it is normal. Function code A6.16 defaults to be 16. After the inverter is powered on, relay terminals R1A and R1B are normally closed. Contacts R1A and R1C are normally open. When an EXXX error code appears, the status will be reversed. You can use a multimeter to check whether it is normal. Function code A6.17 defaults to 15. After the inverter is powered on, the relay terminals R2A and R2B are open, and contacts R2A and R2C closed. After the power is cut off, the contact status will be reversed. When measuring the multifunction input terminal of the frequency converter, it can be observed through function code D0.14. Then use the wire to short-circuit the terminal and COM. After shorting X1 COM, the value of D0.14 is 01. After shorting X2 COM, the value of D0.14 is 02. When measuring the AI function of the inverter, you can short-circuit the AI and 10V terminals with wires. D0.16 is the detection value of AI1. And D0.17 is the detection value of AI2. The normal display value should be 10 plus or minus 0.5V. When measuring the AO function of the frequency converter, you can set both A6.30 and A6.31 to 13. Use a multimeter to measure the voltage of AO1 GND and AO2 GND. You can observe the voltage change of the multimeter by adjusting the keyboard potentiometer. Here are the steps to check the driver board. First, set the multimeter to the diode setting. Use the red test lead to test the negative pole of the inverter, and the black test lead to measure the input RS and T terminals of the inverter respectively. The value shall be between 0.480 plus or minus 0.500. This value is different for different models, however, the three-phase values of R, S, and T measured separately by the same inverter will not differ by 0.050. If you use the red test lead of the multimeter to measure the input R, S, and T three-phase of the inverter, the black test leads of the multimeter measure the negative pole of the frequency converter respectively. The value is infinity. The same detection method can be used for inverter circuits. Please note that the entire test process must proceed with the inverter completely powered off. You will hear the sound of the relay closing within 2 to 5 seconds after the inverter is powered on. If you don't hear the relay closing sound, it is necessary to measure whether the +24V power supply on the driver board is normal. If it is abnormal, you need to find the cause of the switching power supply failure. Measure whether there is +24V power between the two pins of the relay coil. If no voltage, it means the relay's drive circuit is burned out. If the relay coil has +24V power and the relay is not closed, it indicates the relay is burned out. Fan operation can be controlled using inverter parameter B2.15. Setting B2.15 to 1 will make the fan work all the time. The fan power supply pin will output a 24V voltage, which can determine output voltage and fan problems. If the digital tube of the inverter keyboard does not light up or flickers and does not stay on after powering on, you should check whether the switching power supply is abnormal. When the driving board switching power supply is normal, the switching power indicator light and 5V power indicator light will light up. Otherwise, there should be a short circuit in the switching power supply. Then, the driver board should be checked for obvious signs of burnout and whether there is any foreign matter causing a short circuit. This is the schematic diagram of the wiring interface between the driver board and the control board. The cable interface has one pin on the square pad on the bottom of the board, which can measure +24V COM, +5V GND, +15V GND, -15V GND power supplies in sequence to see if they are normal. When it is abnormal, you need to check whether the MOS tube and rectifier diode are burned out and whether chip 2844 is enabled. And also use an oscilloscope to measure whether the gate drive waveform of the MOS tube is normal.